Let's move on out page 243. You got some out there looking at 243. It's E flat.
Oh. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Who's got a special song tonight?
Come
on up. Come on up. Come on, Savannah.
Loves the broken ones, the ones that need a little patching. 17-year-old girl shows up all black and blue, with needle tracks in her left arm, almost too weak to stand. She says, I'm lost and I need help. It's Maggie takes her hand and says, come on in. She loves the broken ones, the ones that need a little patching up. She sees a diamond in the rough and makes it shine like new. Really doesn't take that much, a willing heart and a tender touch. If everybody loved like she does, there'd be a lot less broken ones. Call her an angel, she'll be quick to say to you, she's just doing what the one who died for her would do.
Thank you.
Love the broken ones, the ones that need a little patching up. See the diamond in the rough and make it shine like new. Really doesn't take that much, a willing heart and a tender touch. If everybody loved like she does, there'd be a lot less broken ones. There'd be a lot less broken ones.
Amen. Amen.
And I believe that I'm going to sing tonight is, it's a little different. I think it's number 30, Phil. There's something that I want, especially the young people, to realize. When you step out for God, I know it's terrifying because you feel like you're all by yourself and everybody's looking at you. No one realizes that you're not alone.
Amen.
You're never, never alone. It doesn't matter if you're standing there all by yourself. God has promised that He is always there.
Amen.
Anything you do for Him, He is always going to be there with you.
Right.
You're not going to be by yourself.
Right, Lord.
You know, there's been a lot of times in my life that I have felt like it took me a long time to realize this. The trials that I faced, the troubles that I went through. And I believe Miss Dishman can tell you. He's there every step of the way. And regardless of what this world thinks, everybody puts their faith in so many things in this world. I would rather make a spectacle of myself for Jesus than anything that's in this world.
Amen.
Amen. That's good.
I hope that this song's a blessing to you.
You will.
For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon and of Barak and of Samson and of Jephthah and of David also and Samuel and of the prophets who through faith subdued kingdoms, wrought righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched the violences of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of weakness were made strong, waxed valiant in fight, turned to flight the armies of the aliens, women received their dead husbands, raised to life again, and others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. Glory to God. And others had trial of cruel mockings and scourgings, yea, moreover, of bonds and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn asunder with saws, they were tempted, were slain with the sword, they wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world is not worthy. They wandered in deserts and in mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. And of these all, having obtained a good report through faith, received not the promise. God, having provided some better thing for us, what they without us should not be made perfect. Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about, are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. Amen. I can't hold it, okay? And here we go. And owe no man anything but to love one another. For he that loveth another hath fulfilled the law. For this, thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness. Thou shalt not covet. And if there be any other commandment, I like that. I like that, Paul. And if there be any other commandment, it is briefly comprehended in this saying, namely, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. See, because love worketh no ill to his neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfillment of the law. My.
That's true.
Love is the fulfillment of the law. I'm not alone.
No.
I'm not alone. No. Listen. I've got my Savior with me.
Yeah.
Amen. I've got it. I have on his armor of light.
Right. Come on.
That's what Romans chapter 13 calls it. We'll get there as we stroll through this book.
Come on.
Amen. His armor of light.
Bless you, Lord.
You see how all this fits together, doesn't it? You see the order?
Awesome.
Yeah.
John chapter 1, verse 9, and he was the light.
Yeah. That's right.
He is life, and that light is the light of men. In the beginning, God said, let there be light.
That's right.
And boom, there was light. There's the big bang. Amen. This is the message. This is the message. In him there's no darkness at all. Amen. God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. First John chapter 1, verse 9, verse 4, in him there is no darkness at all. If we say we have fellowship with him and we walk in the darkness and we do not the truth, we lie. We fool ourselves. We try to become wise in our own minds, and when we try to become wise in ourselves, we become as fools, morons.
That's right.
Amen. Morons. I'm not alone.
No.
What are you talking about? See that I'm compassed about.
Amen.
Compassed
Amen.
About with such great a cloud of witnesses.
Yeah.
Amen. As those who have gone before. I'm not alone. My. I've got my Jesus, number one.
Yeah.
Amen. I've got my papas, plural, number two. My grandmas. Amen. Compassed about. And those that taught me the things of God from this book. Amen. Even when I was a moron. Amen. And thought I knew everything and didn't want to listen to them. Amen. They taught me all of the things of this book. And they're still around me. Amen. I believe that with all of my heart. I believe it when Jesus comes. And when he does, I'll prove it to you. Amen. They're here.
Come on, brother.
That's right.
Amen.
Good.
To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. If the Lord can be with me, they can be with me.
Come on.
Amen. Now that's a fact of the Word of God. And I'm so glad.
Amen.
I'm not alone. Why are you talking about this for, Brother Dean? Because next Sunday. Next Sunday, I'm going to show you why it's so important that we love one another.
Amen.
Right, brother.
Amen.
Come on.
I jumped ahead a little.
Come on.
Love is the fulfillment of the law.
Yeah.
Chapter 13.
Yeah.
It's fulfillment. Why'd you do that for? Because where do you get to the end of chapter 1 of the book of Romans and the beginning of chapter 2? You read that. I want you to read that this week. And I want you to read it slow. And I want you to let it soak into you. Amen. I want you to meditate on it. But I want you to read it with your heart, not your mind.
Right.
Because that's where people trip up on it. They read it with their mind. They try to reason it with the reason of man. Yep. And the mind of man. You'll never understand it till you read it with your heart and allow God's Spirit to let that soak into you and to reveal what that means. He's not talking about, I'm going to let you find that. Amen. I'm going to let you find that.
Mercy, Lord.
We got folks that are tired. Folks that are weary.
Yeah.
Been in a battle.
Mercy, Lord.
Still in the battle.
Come on.
And Satan is relentless. And he will use every means available to attack you, to oppress you, to depress you, to obsess you. We've talked about all those things before. He will use every means available and every means necessary to make you quit.
That's right.
Amen.
To give up.
Yeah.
He can't get your soul.
No.
So what he's going to do, he's going to get your witness.
Sure.
Maybe he'll do it. Maybe he'll find a crack in the armor and he'll weasel in and he'll bring you down through the lust of the flesh. Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe he'll get you so tired and so frustrated, beating your head against a spiritual brick wall.
Come on.
That you'll just say, I'm not doing anybody any good. I just quit. Give up. I've known pastors that have given up. I've known missionaries that have give up.
Sure.
I'm not making any difference. I'm not gaining any ground. I'm not doing anything, so I'm just going to quit. He won. Listen. Listen to me. Don't you buy into that lie. That's what he's whispering in your ear. Just quit. Just give up. Just, can you imagine? Can you imagine that woman with the issue of blood? For all of those, her frustration, her heartbreak, her aggravation and anger and absolute bitterness that she would have had to have been facing and feeling and suffering. And Satan all the while using those men of God, amen, in quotations, to tell her to stay away. You can't come around here.
Yeah.
You can't get around here. She had exhausted every means necessary that she could have available. Everything. Why didn't she just quit? Why didn't she just give up? I mean, Doug, that crowd that day was worse than Neyland Stadium. Amen. On Alabama Saturday. I mean, you couldn't get near that place. You know, people pushing and shoving, knocking her sideways, knocking her down, all that. Why didn't she quit? She didn't quit.
No.
She said, let me do this. Let me just get down. Let me just get down. Let me get down. I know if I could just get to him and kick him. Can you imagine how many times you got kicked in the head?
Really?
You know, crawl. I ain't quitting. I ain't quitting.
No.
Don't step on me. I ain't quitting.
But
if I can just get to the hem, just to the hem of his garment. If I can just reach out one time, I know if I can just get to Jesus and just touch his hem, just the hem of his garment. Amen. Glory. The Holy Spirit did a work in her because she didn't quit. She didn't give up.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Love him enough not to quit.
Yeah.
Understand God loves you enough. Don't quit. Don't give up. We don't fight for victory. We fight from victory.
Yeah.
We've won. The battle's over.
Yeah.
We've won. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, now there's going to be some skirmishes. As we walk through this life, we're going to get into some of that, ain't we?
Yeah.
Amen. We're going to get into some of it. You know what? We already won.
Amen.
Amen.
Here's your word for tonight from God, okay? Don't surrender to a defeated foe.
Yeah, amen.
Don't surrender to a defeated foe. Let's pray. Father God, I thank you. I praise you. I love you, oh God. Thank you for this time that we've had together.
Thank you.
Now, Lord, I pray that you would strengthen us. Strengthen us, God. Renew the strength of our armor. God, if there be a piece cracked, if there be a piece broken, if there be a piece missing in our life, illuminate that to us. Tell us, Father, help us to get it on there. Father, that Satan could not weasel his little weaselly self in. And we'll surrender it all to you and trust it all to you, Father. We thank you for your goodness, your kindness, your mercy, and your grace. I thank you for those great cloud of witnesses, Father. I pray they're cheering us on. I pray they're cheering us on. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
And amen. Glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah. To the Lamb. Amen.
Amen.
You won't have anything.